Welcome to the Brightspace Foundations training. This training will cover navigating Brightspace, an overview of the communication tools in Brightspace, how to build out the content of your course, the most common assessment tools included in Brightspace, assignments, discussions, and quizzes, and other features to know as you get started with Brightspace, such as how to view your course like a student, how to set up notifications, and a note about course availability. This video is part one, which will cover navigation and orientation. Brightspace can be accessed from the CCC website under Faculty Tools from my.ccc.edu or directly by going to brightspace.ccc.edu. Your username and password is the same one you use for all your CCC accounts. Pause this recording while you open an updated internet browser and log on to Brightspace. Understanding the homepage. Once you log into Brightspace, you will land on the homepage, which will look similar to this. The homepage is divided into three parts: the mini bar, the nav bar, and our widgets. No matter where you are in Brightspace, the mini bar will stay static and accessible, so that's where we will start. The first icon on the mini bar is affectionately known as the waffle or course selector, which allows you to search for and switch between courses easily. Next, we have the messages tool, which is where you can access your sent box for any email sent through Brightspace to your students, or where you can view your instant messages. Instant messages are messages sent within Brightspace. They are not emails and they are not instant. It is easy to miss messages from students if they are using the instant messaging tool, so we recommend letting your students know to email you through Brightspace rather than instant message, unless you find yourself preferring this tool. Emails will come directly to your CCC email, whereas instant messages only exist inside of this messaging tool in Brightspace. To the right of that, we have the subscription alerts. This is where you may see notifications for discussion threads you are following or are subscribed to. Next to that is the bell icon or update alerts. This is where you will see notifications for new announcements, status messages, and other alerts. Finally, to the right of that, we have your personal settings. Click on your name to access your profile settings, set up your preferred notifications, and edit your account settings. This is also where you will log out of Brightspace. Moving down from the mini bar, we have the nav bar. The nav bar changes depending on where you are in Brightspace. On the homepage, where we are now, it includes Help, My Brightspace, which has links to your earned awards, class progress, among other things, as well as access to the college community, which is a place to explore self-enroll courses within the CCC community, such as college-specific communities. Once you access one of your courses, you will notice the nav bar will completely change and be specific to that course. We will talk about the course navbar more in depth in a moment. Finally, we have our widgets. The My Courses widget is where you can easily access your current and past courses. They are organized by semester, or you can use the All tab to sort through all your courses in one place, or the Pin tab to find courses you've pinned for quick access. Another widget you will see on the homepage is the Announcements widget, which displays college-wide or district-wide announcements. Note that course-specific announcements will appear on the course homepage, not this main page. Moving on from the homepage, let's access one of our courses and learn more about course navigation. To access a course, simply click on the course tile from the homepage. This will take you to the course homepage. Pause the recording to take a moment and click on one of your courses. A great course to use for this purpose would be your sandbox. This is a course that is typically named your email address-sandbox course, and it is available to new and existing instructors. If you don't have a sandbox, you can contact the help desk to request one. The course homepage is the first stop in your course. You will know you're there because of the course banner. And if you're wondering if you can change it, well, yes, you can. It can be changed by clicking on these three dots that are highlighted on the page. Feel free to pause this recording if you want to explore the banner options now. As we discussed earlier, the navbar changes depending on where you are in Brightspace. Now that we are in a course, the navbar displays your course-specific links. Every course will typically have the same links, and we will go through each one momentarily. The widget layout below the navbar is also relatively consistent from course to course. Both can be changed depending on your role, but we won't be covering that in the foundations training. Let's review the widgets that we have here on the course homepage. First, on the left, we have the course overview, which gives you some details about user access and engagement. You can expand or collapse widgets for your own view to make more space and hide things that aren't as important to you. In this screenshot, the course overview is collapsed. Below that are your announcements. When you create announcements in your class, this is where they will be displayed. You can also access the announcements tool from here to edit, delete, and reorder your announcements. We will spend a little more time later learning the steps to create and publish announcements. On the right side of the page are your updates, content browser, orientation video, and calendar. The updates widget gives information on activity happening in the course, such as unread discussion posts, quizzes that need grading, or assignments that have recently been submitted. Your students get a different view of the updates widget, which includes unread discussions, quizzes that need completing, or assignments that have been graded. The content browser is a mini window into the content tool. We recommend instructors and students alike should access content from the navbar rather than the mini content browser here. Some very important content can be missed if students use this instead of the navbar link. Finally, the calendar displays upcoming activities, assignments, quizzes, discussions that have due dates set in Brightspace. This is a great reason to encourage you to use due dates in your class when creating assignments and quizzes. I like to describe the course homepage as the what's new and what's due. It's not the meat of your course, it's not everything in your course, but it's a good high-level look as a first step before jumping into the real part of the course, which is content. We will spend the majority of our time in the rest of this training talking about content, but let's quickly talk about each item in the course navbar. First, we have course home. That's where we landed. It's our announcements, updates, and the calendar. You can also get to the course home by clicking on the course name just above. Next, we have course admin. Course admin is where you will access all the tools to manage your course. A lot of the tools can be accessed from other places, but this is where they all live. Students cannot see or access course admin. It is your private back-end tool access. Content. This is where all your course material, your syllabus, modules, weekly activities, and essentially anything you want the students to learn and interact with will be organized. This is where you will build your course, and this is where students will access the course material and activities. Content is where you and your students will spend most of the time. We will spend a large chunk of our time diving deeper into content in another video. Finally, the remaining navbar links provide quick access to some regularly used tools. The assessment menu provides direct access to the assignment tool, discussions tool, quizzes tool, rubrics tool, and grades. This is helpful for both instructors and students who need to find one of these quickly without having to navigate through content to find it. The class list menu provides quick access to your roster, or the class list, and groups, which is a tool you can use for group activities and assignments. The student support menu provides access to CCC resources, and the help menu provides access to our help desk, ticketing system, as well as our knowledge base. Take a few minutes to explore the links on the navbar and navigating your course. Don't worry if you're still a little lost. We're just at the beginning. When you're ready, you can move on to the next video in the series.